listeners and subscribers. Hope all is well. So, I hope you're ready to talk about something else other than the COVID-1984 pandemic, okay?
Because we're diving into
Esoteric Pie. Esoteric Pie, what the heck is that about? I have my series, The New World Future, right? And if you've been with my channel for at least a little bit, you'll know what that is. And if you've been with it, for a while,
I had my Bye Bye California series as well. So I'm just starting up a new one, sort of go in depth on some of the subjects I was touching on pre-COVID. And that way you'll know from the title if it includes the Esoteric Pie header or somewhere in there that that's what it's going to be about. So if that's primarily what you're focused on, you get to skip all the other videos that doesn't have that. And if you just like all the content that comes from me, well then, you know, you're more than welcome. But that's what we're going to be doing here. I'm out enjoying the day. It's almost exactly noon and it's beautiful. No mask on outside of the house because I refuse to be a prisoner in my own home, as most of you should. It's absolutely beautiful out. You know, more people should be enjoying this. Anyway, let's get to it.
Listeners and subscribers, hope all is well. So, this is old news, but it's relevant news. As you probably may have heard, probably will hear, about a week ago, week and a half maybe, the Pentagon confirmed 3 videos of unidentified aerial phenomenon. That's what they're calling it now, okay? And one of the videos shows an incident from 2004, and the other 2 were recorded in January 2015, and that's according to Sue Goh, a Defense Department spokeswoman. Okay, the videos became public after their unauthorized release in 2007 and 2017, and the Navy even previously verified their authenticity. So, let's not get too excited here. These are the same videos that have been circulating for years since their release. They're just receiving another round of confirmation, okay? And if you've been following me since at least mid last year, you'll know the Pentagon also confirmed that it investigates UFOs, and right around the same time, the Navy also came out and said it was changing the way they approach and file reports on the subject, okay? Even senators were briefed. It's a whole thing. But to be clear, they aren't confirming alien craft, okay? They're acknowledging the phenomena and calling it unknown, which is a load because, of course, they know something. The U.S. government has had their hands in many esoteric pies, okay? But make no mistake, chances are good that these sightings happen far more often than they're disclosed. But the question still remains, what could we be dealing with? And now I'm going to try my darnest to lay out a template that can help you answer that for yourself, because if you haven't been following the subject outside of the mainstream, chances are better than good. You're not getting a very clear picture. Now, on the other hand, there have been those who have been in the game for a long time, okay? Mainstream and alternative, decades or more. And they're going to be a bit more ahead of the crowd that hasn't. But unfortunately, that doesn't go far enough if we can't articulate the concept in a way to the layman where they can begin to comprehend it, okay? Because you wouldn't talk to somebody who hasn't seen a movie as if they had, right? Instead, what you might do, give them a general overview of the storyline from beginning to end, maybe highlight some of the dynamics between the pro and antagonist, okay? You know, the mystery was solved, the good guy went bad, hero beats villain. It's simple, all right? So that being said, if you knew nothing about the subject, or only very little, you're gonna find that there's many schools of thought out there, and that can turn most people off on its own. I understand that. But when you do get down to the bare bones of it, things generally fall into only a few umbrella categories, okay? A few major questions and explanations. The major questions are essentially, what are these entities? Where do they come from? What do they want? And, you know, are they predominantly physical or metaphysical? And by metaphysical, I mean, do they inherently transcend physical matter or the laws of nature in some way without the need of technology or an apparatus or something like that? Now, that's the questions. The major explanations you're likely to hear from most folks are angels and demons, extraterrestrials from another planet, beings from alternate dimensions or realities, and, you know, just the run-of-the-mill covert experimentation by humans. Okay, that's the lion's share of explanations. However, those explanations, they mostly cover what are they and where do they come from, okay? the answer to the physical or metaphysical question is easy enough because some appear to be one while some appear to be the other, and still others are somehow both, if you pay attention to lore and things like that. As far as what they appear to want, it usually has something to do with agendas that are either self-serving or service to others, okay? And now, as you can probably tell, you know, I'm not going too deep into anything here because I'm trying to make this as 101 as possible, okay, and just hit the high point. So in a nutshell, those are really the major questions and explanations you're almost inevitably bound to run into on most abduction cases, okay? Contact experiences, sighting, general lore, on like that. And what's interesting is it seems no matter where you turn on this particular rabbit trail, something always leads back to the notion that world governments on many levels of this know more than they let on. Because when you listen to people who know and whose jobs it is to know, like current or ex-pilots, Navy, defense and intelligence officials, okay, you begin to know. And then most people begin to suspect there's something more going on than meets the eye. Now, really, no matter what we may have landed on they might be or what they truly are, government disclosure will probably look one of two ways, okay? They're either our saviors or our enemy. And if one wanted to gauge how the world would respond to either scenario, you can look no further than the world's COVID reaction as a great modern example, okay? Our response to COVID let those who are watching know how to modulate their next approach. And this includes things like what ideas and perceptions to feed the people through news outlets and other forms of media, all in an attempt to tailor our reaction, to predictively program us. Because take a look at this. Over 90% of the media is controlled by a handful of companies, and that includes movies, music, television, print, streaming, okay, the news. So if they did or didn't want you to know something, you would or wouldn't know about that thing. That was true for COVID, and that's true for the subject at hand. And really, it's not as if this information is unavailable, though methodically it will be. It's that it doesn't always get covered, and if it does, it really gets a fair shake, okay? The media is supposed to aid us in holding power accountable, but instead they're acting like they're a public relations firm, okay? And, you know, the reason I even mention or bring any of this up is because it's important, okay? There have been those who've always asked these kinds of questions in the past, but soon there's about to be those who have never asked these questions before. And I think we've got to give them a fighting chance to think about these things on their own before the powers that be go COVID on the alien subject, okay? Because then it's too late. Once countries, leaders, and officials get together on how they'll disclose things to the greater public and a worldwide narrative evolves, people are just going to turn off their thinkers, put on their bibs, and the spoon feeding will commence. So while I'm not getting too deep into this today, I will be in subsequent videos with the title or with the Esoteric Pie header somewhere in the title. So stay tuned. We have more coming up.